Hello viewers, this is an educational video worth watching by every teacher, every student and every parent of our country. Human values constitute an important aspect of our personality and serve as guiding principles for an individual. A sensible citizen is made, not born. Just as we learn sciences and languages, we should also learn values in order to become a specialist in those lessons that are fundamental to living in harmony with nature and the society. In this video, we will touch the basics of values, morals, ethics, aspirations, education, conduct, harmony, self-discovery, and karma. We might have seen the cases in public transports where people often quarrel on the issues about seat. Court of law cannot compel me to offer my seat to a woman unless it is reserved for the woman. What is that virtue which sparks our mind and motivates us to offer our seat to a woman with an infant, a senior citizen, or an ill person? Such virtues are the values that we get from our family and our society. In literary meaning, value can be defined as a principle that promotes well-being or prevents harm. An estimated or appraised worth or price of a certain object at a certain time. Values are the qualities or the characteristics or ideas about which we feel strongly. Values are standards to guide our action, our judgments, and our attitudes. Values are the principles, standards, or qualities considered worthwhile or desirable for our conduct. And our values affect our behavior, our goals, and our decisions. Values govern our thoughts, and our thoughts are translated into our actions. Our actions, they form our habits. And from our habits, we can derive our self-value. Values give direction and consistency to our behavior. Values help us know what to and not to make time for. Values establish a relationship between us and the world. Values set the direction of our life. And what do we understand with integrity? Is defined as the unity and harmony of thoughts, words, and deeds or our actions together with open-mindedness. Watch your thoughts, they become words. Watch your words, they become actions. Watch your actions, they become habits. Watch your habits, they become character. And watch your character, it becomes your destiny. That is why in Indian philosophy, great emphasis is given that each one of us must inculcate pious thoughts, good thoughts, or suvichar. I am human, I make mistakes, I fall, I cry, sometimes I talk without thinking first, sometimes I judge others, sometimes I do things I regret. I am human, I laugh, I love, I live, I learn. I am so very grateful to the Almighty that I am a human in this life and not a fish, not an animal or a reptile. Life is a universal objective value. We value our own life and the lives of others. And where do we get values? We get values from our home, from our family, from our school, from our society, from our friends, from TV or media, from religious institutions, from poetry or music, from books, from our culture, from our employers, or the time periods in which we are grown. But basically, we get values from our home, from our family, and from our school. Up to the age of 8 years, children get values from their parents and family. From age 9 years to 13 years, students get values from teachers, schools, or heroes of sports or the media. Age 14 to 20 is critical, where students start relying more on values and vision of their peers than parents. And during this age, parents are required to keep an eye on the friend circle of their children, whether they are getting values because of peers or they are getting peers because of their values. And by the age of 21 years, values are established. However, the values are tested from time to time. Our behavior greatly depends on the values which we get from our family and from the society. And happiness comes from letting values decide our behavior and our goals. Human actions become dangerous when it is deprived of human feeling. When they are performed with feeling and respect for human values, all activities and actions become constructive. Values can be categorized in 6 categories: moral values, material value, aesthetic value of objects or the buildings, intrinsic value, extrinsic value, and the universal value. Whether the currency note of 1000 rupee is of any value today? Obviously no, because that piece of paper had extrinsic value, which is lost. Whereas the evergreen old Hindi songs of 1970s or 80s, they are still liked by the people because they have intrinsic value. What are moral values? Morals are habits or behavior based on the principle of right conduct rather than legality. And morals are the rules which people use to guide their behavior and thinking. Our moral values and respect for the universal life value sets us apart from our colleagues and neighbors. Though the boundary between the meaning and domains of 3 words, values, morals, and ethics, is blurred, and these are similar in a way, however, values are considered the basis of harmony in our relationship at individual level, and valueless living is a life full of mistakes. Morals are the basis of harmony in community, and immoral living is sin and leads to crime. Ethics is the basis of harmony in society and social order. Unethical living leads to imbalance, exploitation, struggle, and conflict or war. We must understand 6 core values: trustworthiness, respect, responsibility, fairness, caring, and citizenship. I was complaining for not having a pair of shoes until I met a person who had no feet. Each one of us must be thankful to the Almighty for everything that He has blessed to us, because the life of people is much more challenging than the life we are enjoying. Bad is never good until worse happens. We count our miseries carefully and accept our blessings without much thought. Kindness is a language which the deaf can hear and the blind can see. Let's strengthen our kindness muscles. If you want to feel rich, just count all the things you have that money can't buy. Accomplished architect Frank Lloyd Wright had said, "All fine architectural values are human values, else not valuable." What do we understand about ethics? Ethics can be considered a group of moral principles or set of values that define or direct us to the right choice. These are well-established standards of right or wrong that prescribe what humans ought to do. Ethics are values in action. Ethics is the policy of living in the society and way of living which nurtures the order in the society. Ethics is knowing the difference between what you have the right to do and what is right to do. Each one of us make dozens of moral choices daily, like go to school or the workplace or pretend sick, help our classmates or act selfish, tell the truth or tell a lie, obey the traffic speed limit or ignore it, keep our marriage vows or break them, meet our children's emotional need or ignore them, pet the cat or kick it, apologize for our mistakes or create nuisance, attend our old parents or ignore them. Our decision in all such cases depend on the set of values that we have got from our family and from our society. Morals are concerned with the judgment of goodness or badness of human action and character. Exhibiting goodness or correctness of character and behavior depends on the moral education that we have received. Morals are something, those are arising from our consciousness, the sense of right and wrong. Filling out an application form for a job is normally a neutral act, but deciding whether to tell the truth or concealing facts on the application is a moral decision. Nowadays, many people express their concern on lack of values and ethics in young generation as well as in professionals. However, teachers must observe highest standards of ethics and values. No profession can really exist without a code of ethics to guide the conduct of its members. Our decisions during any dilemmas depends on the set of values inside us. When only two actions are possible and both produce good consequences, which one should be chosen? The morally preferable action is the one that produces the greater good. And similarly, in cases where two actions are possible and both produce harmful effects, the morally preferable action is the one that produces lesser evil. And how should we decide the degree of goodness? Let us consider a case where we have to take the decision, and one decision will benefit only one individual or yourself, and second decision will help your entire family. Then the decision taken in the interest of family would carry higher value or would be the greater good. And similarly, in the cases where our decisions has to benefit the community or the nation, then obviously decision taken in the interest of the nation would carry highest value. Wrong is wrong even if everyone is doing it, and right is right even if no one is doing it. And that is why each one of us should be indulged in good deeds or the good karmas. Do good things and good things will come your way. No kind deed has ever lacked its reward. Our endeavor should be to lead this life with fun and earn our livelihood while observing established standards of ethics and values. Ethical practices in our profession and business may not be always profitable. However, we should not compromise on ethics and values in order to increase our profitability. Ethics are values in action in the society, and there are no code of ethics. The ethicist nevertheless is interested in the question, under what circumstances is a person to be considered culpable? Humility does not mean believing oneself to be inferior, but to be freed from self-importance. It is a state of natural simplicity which is in harmony with our true nature and allows us to taste the freshness of the present moment. I am really concerned with the role of education in holistic development. All units around us exhibit definite conduct except humans. The conduct of trees and plants is based on their seed, the conduct of birds and animals is based on their breed. However, the conduct of human beings is based on their education. Does the current education system promote these? We may say yes, but then why do we experience lack of values in young generation? In modern education system, we may focus on self-study, self-discovery, self-exploration, self-investigation, self-empowerment, self-organization, self-expression. But among all, the missing thing is the realization of self, which is really missing in the education system. And if we include this component in the education system, so this set becomes the set of virtues of a great education. Your relationship with yourself sets the tone for every other relationship you have. Your relationship with yourself. Think about it. If you want to truly enjoy your life, you must be at peace with yourself. When our thoughts, words, and actions are in harmony, we are in a state of mental peace and happiness. If we wish to experience a cleaner and brighter society, each one of us may discover ourselves. So, the voiceless voice be heard and self be brought in harmony with it. A man asked Lord Buddha, "I want happiness." Lord Buddha said, "First remove I, that's ego, then remove want, that's desire. See, now you are left with only happiness." What lies behind us and what lies before us are small matters compared to what lies within us, our culture, our values. The greatest discovery in life is self-discovery. Until you find yourself, you will always remain someone else. So become yourself. We are not human beings on a spiritual journey. Actually, we are spiritual beings on a human journey. As per Sri Raman Maharshi, the only useful purpose of the present birth is to turn within and realize the self. There is nothing else to do. After self-discovery, people can be aware of how miserable they really are and how happy they can be. What is necessary to change a person is to change his awareness of himself. Self-discovery is a journey of questioning yourself. What we want most, what we think about most, how do we intend to earn money, how do we use our money, what we do with our leisure time, which company or type of people we enjoy, who and what we admire, what disappoints us or give us sorrow, what we laugh at, and how can we make our life more meaningful. What you discover on your own is always more exciting than what someone else discovers for you. Oneself has to discover self. Once you reach the summit of your own heart, you will see beauty is everywhere. The feelings, emotions, or values are: trust is the basic value and the foundation of all the relationships. Then respect, affection, care, guidance, reverence, glory, gratitude, and love, which is the complete value. All the feelings are within us. Understanding only makes us aware, and once we are aware of it, there is continuity of these feelings and we are able to behave accordingly by fulfilling them, by observing all the ethical standards and established values. Each one of us must ponder and explore further the meaning in letter and spirit of the words values, God, nature, self-discovery. What are human aspirations? What is happiness? What is prosperity? Is there any difference in need and greed? What are our desires? What is harmony? Self, family, society, and nature. What are different levels of harmony? Emotions, values, and what is right conduct? What is ethical behavior? Most humbly, I request each one of you to develop that zeal or fire to discover yourself and step into the fire of self-discovery. This step will not burn you. It will only burn what you are not. And the moment you discover yourself, you may choose to live by choice and not by chance, to be motivated and not manipulated, to be useful, not used, to make changes, not excuses, to perform and excel, not compete, to maintain your self-esteem and not self-pity, to listen to your inner voice and not to the random opinion of others. A person is born alone and dies alone, and one experiences the good and bad consequences of his karma alone, and one goes alone to hell or the supreme abode. Pure thoughts and state of mind as an individual observe at cremation ground and in hospitals. If remains always with people, then welfare of all is certain. Each one of us shall be recycled again and again in time, space, matter. Only our good deeds in this life shall be helpful in bringing fortune in coming life. Let us try to overcome human weaknesses like anger and greed. No one who does good work will ever come to a bad end, either here in this life or in the world to come. I am surprised to observe that people are indulged in making money by adopting many unethical practices, keeping aside our value system, our family and social values, or established standards of professional ethics. There is no fun in spending this limited life in chasing unlimited money. We should always believe in God, because there are some questions that even Google can't answer. Here is an assignment for the viewers. You are expected to list at least 5 values in each of the following categories: family values, social values, moral values, intellectual values, and professional or career values. So time is limited. Please hurry up and complete this assignment. I don't expect anybody to use unfair means or follow any unethical practices in this assignment. So for your ease, I am displaying the list before each one of you. And now you can choose the values which fits in each category. My humble request to each one of my viewers, the students, the parents, the professionals, and the teachers is please try not to become a man of success by adopting unethical practices and unfair means, but please become a person of values. Journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. This is the first step of mine in strengthening value-based education in order to experience a cleaner and brighter society in the time to come. Thank you so much.